इतिहास की दिलचस्प कहानियों के लिए बेल आइकन दबाएं और सब्सक्राइब करें लिव हिस्ट्री इंडिया।
सपनों का शहर मुंबई अपनी ऊंची इमारतों, चहल पहल भरी गलियों और उसमें छिपे चंद अनमोल रत्नों की वजह से जाना जाता है। हो सकता है कि पहली बार सुनने पर विश्वास ना हो, लेकिन ये सच है कि इस आधुनिक महानगर को गुफाओं का शहर भी कहा जा सकता है। इस व्यस्त शहर के भीतर और आसपास बौद्ध एवं हिंदू आस्थाओं पर आधारित प्राचीन गुफाएं हैं, जिन्हें प्राचीन काल में चट्टानों को काटकर बनाया गया है। एलिफेंटा, कन्हेरी और महाकाली गुफाओं को तो आमतौर पर सब जानते हैं, लेकिन बोरिवली की मंडपेश्वर गुफाओं के बारे में बहुत कम लोगों ने सुना होगा। जहां एक तरफ कन्हेरी और महाकाली गुफाओं की खुदाई बौद्ध समुदाय के लोगों ने करवाई थी, वहीं मंडपेश्वर, जोगेश्वरी और एलिफेंटा की गुफाओं की खुदाई शैव समूह द्वारा की गई थी। मंडपेश्वर गुफाएं हिंदू देवता शिव को समर्पित हैं। ये गुफाएं बेसाल्ट की चट्टानों को काटकर बनाई गई हैं, जिन्हें अब बोरिवली उपनगरी में माउंट पोइंसर के नाम से जाना जाता है। इतिहासकार वॉल्टर स्पिंग के मुताबिक इन गुफाओं की खुदाई कलाचुरी राजाओं के काल में 6वीं और 7वीं सदी में हुई थी। इन गुफाओं में पाशुपत संप्रदाय के लोग शिव की उपासना करते थे। भगवान शिव को समर्पित ये गुफाएं सदियों विभिन्न सत्ताओं के अधीन रही है और समय समय पर इनमें बदलाव होते रहे हैं, लेकिन आज इन्हें शिव मंदिर ही माना जाता है। हमने बात की इतिहासकार डॉक्टर कुरुश दलाल से, जिन्होंने हमें मंडपेश्वर गुफाओं की कुछ खास किस्से सुनाए।
The caves, because of this solidity and being made out of rock and not being, you know, that easily damaged by the vagaries of time and other elements, are one of the most important markers of the early historic and very very early medieval period in Mumbai in this region. And along with the caves at Jogeshwari, then they tell us a lot about a period of which we know very little. Archaeologically otherwise. There are essentially two main caves in an L-shaped configuration, the main cave itself and on the left-hand side a secondary cave, and they were interestingly built during what we call the Pashupata period of Shaivite worship, and this is very similar to what is seen at Jogeshwari and especially what is seen at Elephanta. Sadly, since these caves were very much part of the Salsette Island and very much amongst the sphere of usage of the land by people, the Portuguese in turn modified these caves quite greatly.
इन गुफाओं की कहानियाँ सिर्फ प्राचीन युग से चली आ रही शिव पूजा से ही नहीं, बल्कि मध्य युग में ये गुफाएं पुर्तगाली शासकों के अधीन भी रही है। सन 1544 में फ्रांसिस्कन पादरी ने इन गुफाओं के ऊपर एक चर्च बना दिया और गुफाओं का इस्तेमाल तहखाने की तरह किया।
The caves were first used when the Portuguese came here as a chapel. Subsequently, a church was built on top of the cliff on which the caves have been carved, and the caves were then used as a series of crypts in which the bones of the dead were placed. Whilst doing so, in a typically iconoclastic way, the Portuguese destroyed a large number of sculptures. Modified some interestingly, and for reasons that we cannot really fathom, left one panel absolutely intact. So there is a beautiful panel of a dancing Shiva image, what we call a Natesha, or what is very commonly known as a Nataraja image, and this image seems to have survived with very very minimal intervention at all. On its side would have been what we believe is a Lakulisha image, which is an image that is normally seen in tandem with the Natesha images. This has been completely obliterated during the Portuguese period. Outside, one of the individual panels has been modified and the deity inside has been completely obscured and turned into a beautiful cross. But the Gandharva images on the top bearing flowers have been maintained because they very easily segue into the position of angels bearing flowers onto the cross. So there's a very interesting syncretism of art in some ways. These caves were not really used once the church was built on top, and the remains of the church are still very much there. The caves and the church are protected monuments with the Archaeological Survey of India. When the Portuguese were finally driven out of the Salsette Island and of the northern dominions of the Portuguese Empire in India by the Marathas under the Peshwas, the caves were liberated and a Shivling was set up once again in the central cave. In the late 18th century, this entire area came under the purview of the British once again. And as in once again, there was a European power. But the British were more politically cued in. They did not in any way interfere with the Mandapeshwar caves. And the church that was rebuilt by the local Christian community was rebuilt a little distance away. This is the famous IC Church, or the Church of the Immaculate Conception, that exists and is probably one of the biggest churches and the biggest Christian colonies in the Salsette Island today. So the caves are very interesting from an art historical point of view. They're very interesting because they belong to the 6th, 7th century AD. And they tell us a lot about the life of the people in this space.
इन गुफाओं की एक दिलचस्प बात ये भी है कि यहाँ प्राचीन काल के खेल या बोर्ड गेम की निशानियाँ भी दिखाई देती हैं।
There are two very clear ancient game boards that have been carved into the floors of the caves at Mandapeshwar. One of them is a classic strategy game, or what is often called Vag Bakri and other variants of that game. The second one is even more interesting. It's actually the precursor of backgammon. And there's a lot of debate about exactly where this came from. We know that the earliest boards for this game originate in Arabia. And it seems to have come to India at some point, then been exported out of India where it completely disappeared. And then in its newer avatar, it comes back to India very much later during the British and American periods of contact. So these two games have been carved into the floors of the caves. And what is really very interesting here is that it's telling you that if this game actually came from Arabia, then there was definitely some kind of contact during this period. And the nature of the port, the nature of the creek, all bundled together speak of a very interesting kind of syncretism between traders that we don't see in the later periods. And the backgammon game is not a very common game seen etched on the floors of caves, be they Buddhist, Hindu or Jain. So in that sense, it is a very important addition to the repertoire of board games carved in rock cut caves. If you go up to the top of the caves, what you will realize from where the church ruins stand today is that you can see very clearly the creek coming up. And this would have been a very interesting lookout point for the people who took care of the caves, for the people who worshipped at the caves, to see incoming and outgoing vessels and trading ships that would be coming in here. So this automatically tells us that there was most definitely a very early medieval or a late historical occupation in this region at one time, of which sadly the only traces today are the Mandapeshwar caves.
सन 1744 में चर्च को उजड़ने के लिए छोड़ दिया गया और धीरे धीरे गुफा में शिव की पूजा की परंपरा शुरू हो गई। अब ये गुफाएं भारतीय पुरातत्व विभाग के अधीन है और इस भागदौड़ वाले शहर में रेगिस्तान के बीच हरियाली की तरह सुकून की मिसाल है। गुफाओं की देखरेख करने के लिए सिर्फ एक ही व्यक्ति होता है और दर्शन के लिए आने वाले इक्का दुक्का लोग। गुफाएं चारों तरफ से ऊंची इमारतों से घिरी है। 21वीं सदी मुंबई की यही विशेषता है। इस दौड़ते शहर में प्राचीन इतिहास की झलक हमें मंडपेश्वर की इन गुफाओं में आज भी दिखाई देती है।